I got this idea when President Obama was first in office, and there seemed to be some bubbling under, some resentment towards people of color in this country. And I was realizing the people who are in charge, who have got everything in this country for 400 years, if they're mad, well, then I want to sort of figure and talk to some people.
Yeah, that's right. This cut goes out to all y'all that's been missing us for mad years. One love.
Anything that, yeah, even right, with Obama, you know, that's you know, that's, we're crossing lines now.
Yeah.
Taking away our country.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Nobody was going around saying, let's take our country back from, you know, George Bush, Bill Clinton, the other George Bush, Ronald Reagan, or whatever. All of a sudden, we get a black president, and we got to take our country back. Well, whose country are they trying to take back, and where are they trying to take it back to?
My wandering got my ass wondering, where Christ is in all this crisis. Hating Satan never knew what nice is. Check the papers, well, I bet on ISIS. More than your eye can see and ears can hear.
NCAA will not even allow you to hold a tournament at your school because of this flag. They're not going to let you know something like that, huh?
Huckleberry Finn. You may have read it as a child, but increasingly schools across the country are choosing not to include it in their curriculums because of its use of the N-word. It's used more than 200 times in Huck Finn. Now the editors of New South Books are doing something about that. They're publishing a new edition of The Adventures of Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn, minus the N-word.
You know, people jumped on us that we were censoring Twain. We thought we were doing the opposite of censoring Twain. We thought we were giving his book greater exposure. It's not like if you don't want the expurgated edition, it's not like you can't get the other one.
Right.
I mean, not only are they all out there, but we sell them too.
Went to New York at that time. I went in the movie, and when I got in the movie, it was mixed. And I wasn't sure where I was supposed to sit.
First time I ever heard somebody call me a nigger was in Cleveland, Ohio, not in Montgomery, Alabama.
It's because I'm white that I shouldn't use the word?
Yeah, it's something about hearing you say it that
white person should use that word.
You know, I feel differently from other people. I don't like it when you use the word. When you say it, it's a different connotation.
I'm not sure I understand why.
I know you probably wouldn't. I probably could never explain the way I feel.
Long as Barbara Walters been doing television, she should have the right to say
it. I've never been called the N-word. Now, I've had the look like it was really close to that.
Me, you probably get my shoe thrown at you.
Because if we don't come together and acknowledge who this world belongs to and everything that's in it.
Something happening, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over.
Because I look, people used to say when I was growing up, I used to look like MC Search. Back in the day. Back in the day, yeah.
Everybody look what's going down.
Catfish?
No, whitey.
Whiteys?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's not what it's called.
Uh-huh, it's called whiteys.
What's a whitey? I thought I was a whitey.
You'll notice the sign that says where miracles still happen. Come be with us because God can still do a miracle for you.
All you sleeping souls, wake up and take control of your own cipher. And be on the lookout for the spirit sniper trying to steal your life. You know what I'm saying? Look with this eye yourself for peace. Give thanks, live life, and release. You dig me? You got me?
Everybody knows what's going down.
But is it all right? Is it tight?